We can start addressing these kind of issues by practicing adaptive design. Let's start by talking about the when of adaptive design, or at what points do you want to begin adapting your UI? The basic idea of adaptive design is that you change your UI based on the screen size. That is, your UI adapts to the amount of horizontal or vertical space that you have. We do this by introducing what we call breakpoints. Breakpoints are the points at which your UI changes. For example, you could show another column of content once your screen width is 600 dip or larger. 600 dip is therefore a breakpoint in your UI. Now you might be wondering, how should I choose these breakpoints? Well, the material spec identifies some common breakpoints. While you can start with these, it's important to ensure your breakpoints make sense for your content. It's important to think content first. You can then think of the breakpoints as the point in which your UI literally breaks for the content it's trying to present. So what does it mean to be content first? In this case, it means starting by figuring out what the constraints are for your content and then figuring out the breakpoints from there. Let's return to some of the layouts we looked at in lesson one and see how they might work on larger devices. Now, as the screen width increases with this layout, the line length for text increases, making it harder to read. So you might want to have a breakpoint somewhere where the line length exceeds 45 to 75 character guideline. In this form layout, on wider devices, there's too much unused space here on the right, making it feel very unbalanced. You might set a breakpoint round about, say, here to rebalance the layout. In this example, see how these two buttons take up half the width of the screen. On wider layouts, this starts to get quite awkward, around about, say, this point. So that might be a breakpoint. Also notice how maintaining a constant height and center crop image starts to break down on larger sizes. It ends up showing this kind of small sliver of the whole image greatly blown up. Lastly, the left-aligned content can start to feel unbalanced, leaving large empty areas on the right of the screen. Choosing breakpoints based on content requirements is more future-proof than basing them on a specific set of devices. You'll know those requirements will be satisfied no matter what devices get thrown your way. Okay, so now that we know we want to do something different when a UI gets to these breakpoint sizes, in the next section, we'll talk about how you do this with code.